Myself, B. Ramkumari, Department of Mathematics, KSR College of Arts and Science for Women, Trichur. Now let us see the subject complex analysis. In complex analysis, unit 1, complex integration. Complex integral is defined as, consider a function f of z. F of z be a continuous function on a piecewise smooth path C represented by z of t equal to x of t plus I into y of t, where t lies between a to b. Then integral over C f of z dz equal to integral over a to b f of z of t into z dash of t into dt. This definition is the rule for real line integrals. If f of z equal to u of xy plus v, I into v of xy, then it can be restated as integral a to b u into dx minus v into dy plus I into integral a to b v dx plus u dy. Then we see the Cauchy integral theorem and Cauchy integral formulas. Cauchy definite integral of a complex valued function of a real value can be defined as f of t equal to v of t plus I into v of t, which is assumed to be a piecewise continuous function defined in the closed interval a to b. Then the integral of f of t is defined as integral a to b f of t dt equal to integral a to b u of t dt plus I into integral a to b v of t dt. Next we see the first version of Cauchy's integral formula. The statement of Cauchy's integral formula is, let G be an open subset of the plane and f from G to C an analytic function. If gamma is a closed rectifiable curve in G such that n of gamma w equal to 0 for all w in C to G, then for A in G to gamma, n of gamma A into f of A equal to 1 by 2 pi I into integral gamma f of z by z minus a into dz. This is the Cauchy's integral formula. Then we see the most important principle, meaning minimum modulus principle. It can be stated as, let D be a complex domain and let f of z be a function holomorphic and non-vanishing in D. Suppose that is z naught belongs to D such that modulus f of z naught less than or equal to modulus f of z such that z belongs to B. Thank you.